Hi everyone, thank you for joining me. Here's an update about that volcanic eruption there in the Canary Islands on the island of La Palma. Here we have an image of emergency workers watching the slow movement of the magma. It's supposed to reach the ocean sometime around 8 p.m. tonight, their time. There is a lot of people who don't know where the Canary Islands are. Well, it's about 60 miles off the coast of Africa, 60 miles from Morocco. Here we have the islands, and here we have the continent of Africa. Up over here is the Strait of Gibraltar and the Mediterranean Sea. About 5,000 people have been evacuated, and 100 homes have been destroyed. Another image of the slow-moving lava from Reuters. I marked out in red where the eruption started, and this is not far from an eruption in 1585 where 5 people were overcome by the ash and the gases and died. The lava is a mixture of basalt and what they call depleted rhyolite. It's full of gases. People often want to know how long will this eruption last. Well, in 1585, it lasted from May 19th through August 10th. So that's almost 3 months of eruption. Here we have a list of the different eruptions going back to 1430. That was the earliest known eruption. It could have been 1440. They're not quite sure. This would make it the 8th eruption for La Palma. The last eruption was in 1971. 50 years ago. So it's kind of amazing. They have eruptions there every 50 to 100 years, and it's been 50 years since the last eruption. This eruption is taking place in an area that they know is a caldera. They know that the magma chamber is somewhere between 7 to 11 kilometers below sea level. This thing isn't near being done because it's still having earthquakes. Here we have a 2.3 that's on EMSC. That was 5 kilometers in depth, a 2.5, 7 kilometers in depth. So that would make the earthquake probably near the roof, the top of the magma chamber. Also, we have a 2.4, that was 10 kilometers, so that would be in the magma chamber. This magma intrusion, the eruption up here, all started with this earthquake that originally they said was between a 3.8 and a 3.6. They have now upgraded it to a 4.2. The island of La Palma is mostly agricultural, raising animals, and they really depend on tourism. The population of the island is about 85,000 people, and it is one of 8 volcanic islands that were all developed by volcanism as they slowly moved across what's called a hot spot, where the plume of magma comes up through the earth, and La Palma is the youngest of these islands. As the oceanic crust moves across, the plume stays in the same spot and slowly develops these islands. Volcanologist Vincent Soler, who is Spain's high council, member of the scientific committee of the volcano risk prevention plans, said part of the island's southwest coast was at risk of landslides and rock falls. More likely what would happen, it would fall off in sections, not one big lump, but there is a chance of the southwest flank of collapsing into the ocean and creating a tremendous mega tsunami. The last time that happened was probably 560,000 years ago. In 1949, there was a major eruption up in the same location. I drew out the rift that opened up. It's a 2.5 mile rift. And according to Dr. Simon Day, about 1/6 of the island's total mass has the possibility of falling into the ocean. But like I said, most scientists think that would happen in stages, not all at once. About 1,200 billion tons of rock would fall into the ocean, according to Dr. Simon Day. And according to the History Channel, a mega tsunami of 30 to 100 feet high could then, anywhere from 6 to 8 hours later, hit the East Coast. Scientists doing their research figures a collapse happens about every 100,000 years. So this latest eruption is linked to the Terminiti caldera. I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing that wrong. The Spanish Prime Minister Pedro Sanchez arrived today on the island after canceling his trip to New York to the UN General Assembly. The only basic income actually the island has is tourism, and the Spanish Tourist Minister Reyes Maroto is encouraging people to visit the island to see the wonderful show of the volcanic eruption. About 3 miles from where the eruption is occurring, people are reporting the smell of rotten eggs. About 6 to 9,000 tons of SO2 is being released into the air, and about 360 tourists evacuated from the island. 500 tourists were kicked out of their hotels. Just like before the eruption on El Hierro, which is also an island that is heavily dependent on tourism, they're downplaying the threat of the toxic gases and the magma, and maybe a hydro eruption. They know that when the lava reaches the ocean, which is supposed to be sometime tonight, sometime after 8 p.m., that it's going to release deadly toxic gases. Even though in 1585, five people were overcome by the gases in the ash and died, thank God no one has been hurt or injured from this latest eruption. And at times, the fountain of magma is shooting up about 300 meters into the air. So that would be about 900 feet into the air. And what has happened is they got two vents, two dike intrusions that have opened up. And they think the two trails of magma or lava will meet up together before they enter the ocean. They also fear that when the lava reaches the ocean, that there will be explosions from that heated lava reacting with the water. They're saying that what the people are smelling right now is H2S, which is hydrogen sulfide. The last I heard that air travel from La Gomera, to La Palma had been canceled. And the shipping on the west side of the island is also shut down. So the 360 tourists that evacuated from the island went by ferry to Tenerife, one of the other islands there. And going back to Google Earth, that would be this island right here. This is La Gomera. So air flights from La Gomera to La Palma have been canceled. But the airports on the other islands, they are evidently still open. So on the west side of the island, all shipping has been canceled. If this island did have a collapse, be it in sections or one big lump, it would probably reach the European continent in some areas, I read, in about 10 minutes. That's all they would have to evacuate. And they are very well aware of the risk of a collapse from this island. Here's an image of that 4.3 earthquake that created all the havoc there. And over here on the right is the spectrogram. These are 1 hour increments, and here we have another earthquake. And you can see the magma that came up with that large one. On the right here is the depth of the magma. Or maybe this was the 4.3. I haven't looked up the exact time to tell you, but here you can see this was yesterday, the 19th. There was another significantly large earthquake. And here you can see another one. This is between 11 and 12 hours universal time. Then between 14 and 1500 universal time, you can see here how the magma was coming up between 15 and 1600 hours. and this is between 1700 and 1800 hours. These are harmonic tremors. I've talked about that when I do my Yellowstone report. Between 19 and 20 hours. I wanted to show you this because there is a threat of when the magma reaches the water, it can create a huge explosion. This here is for today, between 6 and 7 universal time. You can see there was another earthquake that opened up the system and brought up some more magma. See that there? Between 7 and 8 today, between 9 and 10 today, 10 and 11 hour today. Again, this is universal time. 16 and 17, I think that's the most, yeah, this is the most recent image. What's going on now? So here's another image of that caldera system and the rims and the rift. And a current image from YouTube. This is from Reuters. Yeah, every so often when the crack opens up, they get a big gush of this magma and the black cloud comes up. You can watch this live. I'll give you a link to this channel if you want. This lava is actually only about 4.8 miles from the ocean. And it's traveling about 2,300 feet per hour. The two fissures that have opened up are only about 650 feet apart. I was watching it last night and there was a new cone that was forming. So that's all I have for you right now. We gotta keep a watch on this thing. One never knows. Any thoughts or comments or questions, we definitely send prayers to all those poor people that are losing their homes. And if times when you're watching you think it's moving very fast, well, it is. It's a mixture of basalt and what they call U-depleted rhyolite. And those of you that follow me know that rhyolite is the worst type of magma lava you can have because it's full of gases, highly toxic gases, highly explosive gases. So if it reaches any of the pockets of the water under this island, or when it reaches the ocean, yeah, I hope people are not downwind from that. So thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please make sure you're subscribed. Sometimes YouTube loves to unsubscribe people. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.